Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
सर्वभूतेषु शान्तिरूपेण संस्थिता नमस्तस्ये 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 नमः नमः
जय जय भद्रे नारायण नमो नमः जय जय लक्ष्मी नारायण नमो नमः नारायण रहते हैं उस भूमि को वैकुंठ कहते हैं। आफ्टर विजिटिंग गंगोत्री एंड उत्तरकाशी वी केम बैक टू देवप्रयाग। देवप्रयाग इज फेमस फॉर द कन्फ्लुएंस ऑफ river Alakananda and Bhagirathi. These two rivers join here to form river Ganga thereafter. We stayed in Kedarnath Samiti rest house, which was on the banks of the river. We were able to see the whole township, including the river, mountains, Raghunath temple, everything from inside the room. This was river Alakananda, which was flowing from Rudraprayag, and this was river Bhagirathi, which was flowing from Gangotri, and this was the place of their Sangam or the confluence. You can mark the color difference between the two rivers. The color of Bhagirathi was greenish, whereas the color of Alakananda was grey. However, the current of water in Alakananda was much stronger than that of Bhagirathi. We crossed the river and went to the other side. This was the view from the Snanaghat side of the river. This was our hotel, prominently visible at the other side. If you see from this side of the river, the Bhagirathi flows from right and Alakananda flows from the left, and both of them join here to form river Ganga. Sangam is religiously very significant. Taking bath in Sangam is considered to be very auspicious. As you can see, there was nice arrangements for the people to take bath in the river. As it was the rainy season, there was a lot of water in the river, which was flooding over both the sides. Mom was very happy to take a holy bath in the place of Sangam.
Devi Sureshwari Bhagavati Gange, Devi Sureshwari Bhagavati Gange, Tribhuvana Tarini Tarala Tarange, Tribhuvana Tarini Tarala Tarange, Shankaramoli Viharini Bhimale, Shankaramoli Viharini Bhimale, Mamamatirastam Tava Pada Kamale, Mamamatirastam Tava Pada Kamale. Bhagirathi Sukha Dayini Matah, Bhagirathi Sukha Dayini Matah, Stava Jala Mahima Nigame Khyatah, Stava Jala Mahima Nigame Khyatah, Naham Jane Tava Mahimanam, Naham Jane Tava Mahimanam, Pahi Kripa Mahi Mam Gyanam, Pahi Kripa Mahi Mam Gyanam. Tab Chen Matah Srotah Snatah, Tab Chen Matah Srotah Snatah, Punarapi Jathare Sopin Jatah, Punarapi Jathare Sopin Jatah, Naraka Nivarini Janavi Gange, Naraka Nivarini Janavi Gange, Kalusa Vinashini Mahima Uttunge.
After taking bath in Sangam, we went to visit Raghunath temple. We had to climb hundreds of steps in order to go to the temple on top of the hill.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
It was very tiring to climb all these steps. However, finally, we reached the temple and had a darshan of Sri Raghunath and other idols in the temple. We stayed in the temple till the evening aarti. When we came back from the temple, it was night and totally dark everywhere. The next morning on 8th August, we left this beautiful place and went for Rudraprayag. This is the Kedar Badri Samiti rest house where we stayed in Rudraprayag. Rudraprayag is one of the five prayags on Himalayas. As per Hindu religion, bathing in Prayag is considered to be very sacred. We first went to see the bathing hut near the river. Rudraprayag is famous for the Sangam or confluence of River Mandakini and River Alakananda. This is a bridge on the river. Standing on the bridge, you can get beautiful views of the river, the Snanaghat, the huge Shiva statue and all the surrounding views. As you can see, there are platforms made at different levels for the convenience of bathing at different levels of water. The environment was wild and exotic. The current of water was very strong in the river. We enjoyed the beauty of the place for some time. Rudraprayag is about 70 kilometers from Devprayag and 165 kilometers from Haridwar. It is situated on Himalayan Mountains, about 650 meters above the sea level. It was the month of August. The temperature of outside was warm, but the temperature of water was very cool. There are ancient temples of Rudranath and Jagadamba in Rudraprayag. As per the mythology, says Narada meditated here for a long time. Thank you. the place of Sangam is considered to be very sacred for taking bath. I got into the river for taking a holy bath. The waves were very strong and pushing me from all sides. It was very pleasant to take bath in the cool river in the warm sunlight. It was a great satisfaction. I was feeling very lucky to have the sacred bath in Rudraprayag.
तब चैन मातः स्रोतः स्नातः तब चैन मातः स्रोतः स्नातः पुनरपि जठरे सोपि न जातः पुनरपि जठरे सोपि न जातः नरक निवारिणी जाह्नवी गंगे नरक निवारिणी जाह्नवी गंगे कलुष विनाशिनी महिमा उत्तुंगे कलुष विनाशिनी महिमा उत्तुंगे
After I finished bathing, mom went into water. The place was very safe for bathing because of the platforms and steps. Mom was quite comfortable to bath alone without needing any support.
Jesang hrudaye ganga bhakti Jesang hrudaye ganga bhakti ते संग भवति सदा सुखमुक्ति ते संग भवति सदा सुखमुक्ति रोगं शोकं तापं पापं रोगं शोकं तापं पापं हर मे भगवते कुमति कलापं.
However, the waves were very strong and were literally pushing her from one place to other. She bathed for a long time till her full satisfaction. Then she did her puja, tarpan, etc. in the holy river. there was a statue of Lord Shiva on the Vaithingat. The statue was about 15 feet high. It was portraying the views of Himalayan mountains around Lord Shiva. We enjoyed the beauty of the place and took some photographs to capture the interesting artwork and these artistic backgrounds. After spending about half an hour near the statue, we left this side of the Vaithingat and went to the other side. We had to climb all these steps to go to the other side of the Vaithingat. As the place was in Himalayas, there was hardly any plain surface. We had to go up and down everywhere. As you can see, on this side there is a huge platform made of red cement. It was like a big roof on the water with cement bench for sitting. This was a marvelous place to enjoy the views of the wild river. From this side, we could see the sangam of the two rivers properly. This narrow stream of the clean water at the left side was River Alakananda, which was flowing from Badrinath. And the river flowing on our right side was River Mandakini, which was flowing from Kedarnath. And this was the Sangam or confluence of both these rivers. After their confluence, they become one as Alakananda and flow towards Devprayag.
Om Namah Shiva.
We enjoyed this beautiful place for a day. Next morning, on 9th August, we left Rudraprayag and continued our journey towards Gourikund, which was about 75 kilometers ghat route from Rudraprayag. We reached Gourikund after a 4 hours bus journey from Rudraprayag. This was the bus stop of Gourikund. Gourikund is located about 2000 meters above the sea level. The place was extremely cold even during summer season. Winter is intolerable and nobody stays here in Gourikund during winter season. This was River Mandakini, which was flowing with a roaring noise. The Himalayan plants were looking very different at this altitude. The plants were looking deep green and the forest was thick and dense. We stayed in a room having four beds and an attached toilet. The room was freezing in extreme cold. From the room itself, we were able to see the wild mountains and river Mandakini. This was the famous hot spring of Gourikund, where people take bath before going to Kedarnath. We also took bath here in this sacred place. I took bath here in this open place, whereas Mom and Bobby took bath on the other side of the wall meant for ladies. This was the famous Gauri temple of Gourikund. You can see the huge bell hanging at the entrance of the Gauri temple. This is the main structure of Gauri Mai temple. The temple is very ancient and famous. We had a cool darshan of Ma Gauri and Ganapati in this temple. This was a small temple of Uma Maheswar Mahadev in front of Gauri Mai temple. After having darshan, we went through this narrow passage to explore the Kedarnath route. This was the place where people were starting their journey to Kedarnath. As you can see, this place is full of ponies. Plenty of ponies and palkis were available here to carry people to Kedarnath. People can pay money and hire the services as per their need. This was the route going towards Kedarnath and this was River Mandakini. It was a beautiful place with enchanting sceneries of springs, forests and mountains. It was already evening. We came back to our hotel to prepare for our next day's trip. Next morning, on 10th August, we started our trekking from Gourikund to Kedarnath. Mom went by a palki and we went by walking. This was the toll gate of Gourikund, where we saw large number of ponies ready to carry pilgrims from Gourikund to Kedarnath. Soon we realized that we were walking much slower compared to the palki. In that case, mom would reach Kedarnath early and would have to wait alone in Kedarnath. So we decided to hire ponies. Kedarnath is 14 kilometers from Gourikund. The route to Kedarnath was much better than the route from Gangotri to Gomukh. There were many shops, restaurants, drinking water, toilets and similar other facilities available all along the way. The price of chips and water bottles were just 20-40% excess, unlike in Gomukh route, where the price was 200-300% higher than the normal price. As we saw, about 20% people were going by ponies and 5% were going by palkis or gandhis, and the rest others were going by walk. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Our speed was faster than palki. We could see mom's palki in our front and very soon overtook her palki.
उदय सिंह जी
जी सर
हां न्याय
सर आपने बोला कर दिया
हां बोला
सर ठीक है सर आपने पहले मैं आपसे बात करूंगा ठीक है चलो चलो
हां तुम इंतजार करना
क्या जाना हां इंतजार कर
The altitude of Kedarnath is 3,585 meters above the sea level and 1,600 meters high above Gourikund. This route remains closed for 6 months during the winter and reopens again in the summer only for 6 months. During the winter, the temple remains closed, the area remains covered with snow, and nobody visits this place. The inhabitants of Kedarnath leave their houses and go down to other places at low altitude. When we halted for some time on the way, mom's palki overtook us. It was like a race and the journey was becoming more and more interesting.
Huh?
The weather was cool and pleasant, the sceneries were beautiful, and the journey was enjoyable. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. There were so many fountains and waterfalls on the way, which we were enjoying one after the other. As I heard from the horseman, the mountain was being called as Mahadev Parvat. We could also see river Mandakini, which was flowing by our side on a wild rocky bed. We were going through Rambada, which was 7 kilometers from Gourikund, a hamlet in between Gourikund and Kedarnath. This huge river Mandakini turns into ice during the winter season. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. As it was painful to sit on the pony, we got down from the pony and took a walk for some time. The route was so familiar to the horses that they were just going by themselves even without any guidance. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. This was Garud Jetty, a small habitation after Rambara and about 3 kilometers before Kedarnath. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya.
Om Namah Shivaya. Aage jiwa na
janne le mod ki
Finally, we reached Kedarnath at 11 o'clock after 4 hours of trekking. The views of snow-covered mountains were simply unbelievable. Anybody can feel that yes, this is the place of God. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. As we reached earlier, we had to wait for mom's palki to come. The palki came after 2 hours at about 1 o'clock. The palki people were very nice. The main person in contact was Uday Singh. As mom said, they had taken good care of her. This was the famous temple of Lord Kedarnath, situated high on Himalayas at an altitude of 3580 meters above the sea level. The temple, which we had seen only in pictures, now we could see in our own eyes. We took a room in a hotel and then visited the temple. I'll show you the detailed views of the temple and its surroundings in the next video. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. Om Namah Shivaya. This was Kedarnath temple. We could not believe our eyes that finally we reached Kedarnath and were standing in front of the temple. Our first job was to take a room in a hotel. Luckily, we got a hotel just by the side of the temple. The temple was clearly visible from there. It was a room with 3 beds and a toilet, which was good enough for us. We spent some time in the room for food and rest. The place was extremely cold. Although in warm clothes, we all were shivering in cold. We were able to see the snow-covered mountain peaks of Nilkant Parbat. This was the view of the temple of Lord Kedarnath as visible from our hotel. After taking rest for a while, we went to visit the temple of Lord Kedarnath.
Tere dar ko chhod ke
किस दर जाऊं मैं तेरे दर को छोड़ के, किस दर जाऊं मैं तेरे दर को छोड़ के, किस दर जाऊं मैं।
जब तुम चले वहां पे आ गए हैं?
नहीं आए,
थोड़ी जल्दी
हमें लगा लो
रामपाल। दिस टेम्पल ऑफ लॉर्ड केदारनाथ इज सिचुएटेड ऑन हिमालयस at an altitude of 3,580 meters above the sea level. As the place is extremely cold, the temple remains closed for 6 months during the winter and reopens only for 6 months during the summer.
Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Har Har Bole. ओम नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय, ओम नमः शिवाय।
There was not much crowd in the temple. We had a clean darshan of Lord Kedarnath. Kedarnath is considered to be one of the 12 Jyotirlingas. As per the mythology, this temple was built by the Pandavas after the Mahabharata war. Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. This was the Samadhi temple of Adi Shankaracharya, which was situated just at the backside of Kedarnath temple. We saw a beautiful idol of Shankaracharya inside this temple. Our next target was to visit Bhaironath temple, which was located on top of a hill. We had to climb about 2 kilometers to go to the temple. It was cloud all around us, nothing was visible, not even the temple nor the mountains. This was Bhaironath temple. There was no temple-like structure. There were some naturally formed idols in the open place. The devotees were doing puja near the idols. Om Namah Shivaya, 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 Om Namah Shivaya. At the time of return from the Bhaironath temple, the sky was clear and we could see the beautiful views of Himalayan mountains. Next morning, we started our return journey from Kedarnath. Uday Singh and his friends came with the palki before 7 o'clock. We paid our last homage to Lord Kedarnath and started our journey towards Gourikund. It was the last opportunity to enjoy the views of the snow-covered mountains. Walking on the Himalayan track was really enjoyable. We took a walk for some time before hiring the ponies. There were many springs and waterfalls on the way. This was one of the bigger waterfalls just by the roadside. As the palki people were walking much faster than us, we were left far behind. So we hired the ponies in order to compensate the delay and increase the speed. Sitting on the pony was really painful because the pony was walking very fast in the slope and the body of the pony was shaking a lot during the return journey. Going down was much faster than going up, We reached Gourikund at about 11 o'clock. Mom's palki also reached at the same time. We straight went to the bus stand and took a bus for Rudraprayag.
Rudraprayag.